Hi everyone, Lee from ESU here. In this video, we're going to talk about how to update your CabControl integrated control unit base box. It's very easy to do. What you'll need to do is go to our website at lokesound.com and click on the downloads link, and then click on the firmware and software link, and then click on the CabControl link for the latest software. Now this is the software for the CabControl ICU box, version 4.2.13. You'll want to click on download, scroll to the bottom, and click download. And this will download the file to your downloads folder on your computer. And there we go. The way we're going to find this, we can actually clear the history. We'll get rid of those. And now we're going to find the file by clicking down here on the file folder icon, and you can click on downloads and it will be the first one at the top, generally because you just downloaded it. So now you'll see it's a zip file. We need to get it unzipped, so we just right click and we're going to click extract all, and we're going to say extract, and it's going to make a copy here of an unzipped folder. And in here is going to be your CabControl update 4-2-13.bci file. This is the file that you'll need to put onto a USB thumb drive for then loading into the CabControl ICU integrated control unit base. So what you'll need to do is at this point plug in a USB stick, and this can be a USB stick of 2 or 4. I think 4 gigs is probably the smallest you can use. I have one that's relatively large here, but it doesn't have to be. When you first plug it in and your computer recognizes the USB stick, you'll want to right click and go to properties and make sure that it's formatted for the file system FAT32. If it is, then you're good to go. If it says something else in here, you'll need to format the thumb drive or the USB disk for the FAT32, and the way you would do that is, again, right click on the icon for it and say format, and you'll see in here the file system that you want to choose on modern computers, modern Windows computers, is the XFAT, which is the default. You do not want the other option, you just want XFAT, and then hit start. Now it will erase the thumb drive, so be very careful. Don't do this on a thumb drive that you're using regularly or you have sensitive files stored on. You'll definitely want to move those files off before you would do this, because it will erase the thumb drive. Be very careful there. Use a brand new one, or move the files off so that only this CabControl update is on the drive if you have to do the format. Once that's done, double check to make sure by right clicking and hitting properties to make sure that it did format for the FAT32. If it did, now you can move the file over. So I'm just going to open the disk in a new window. Now I already have it in here, but I just want to show you how this works. So on the USB thumb drive, you'll need to create a folder with the name CabControl update as all basically one word, but with the C on cab, the C in control, and the C, or the U in update, all capitalized. CabControl update, no spaces, the C, and the U capitalized. Once you've done that, open it up. Open up from your downloads folder the BCI file. And the easiest way to do this, you can right click and do a copy, which is this icon here, or you can see there we can do a control C, and that's how I do it. I just take, highlight it once, and then just do a control C on your keyboard, and we're going to do a control V to paste it. Since it's already here, it's going to ask me if I want to replace. I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to say skip. You would say replace, or you would just put it in there and it would put it in there, and it'll put in the file. So once this one file is in this folder called CabControl update on your USB stick, you're good to go. And what you can do now is just right click on the icon and say eject. It will say you can safely remove it now, and you can then pop it out of your computer. And then in the next part of the video, we'll show you actually how to update it onto the CabControl integrated control unit box. All right, now we've got the CabControl base here. We're going to go ahead and perform the update. And the way we're going to do that is start by popping the little window off the top, and I just use my fingernail. You may have to use a screwdriver, but you can pop it right off. And you'll notice there's some white buttons and a screw. And what we're going to look for is the button nearest the screw. That is the update button for the CabControl integrated control unit base. And what we're going to need to do is hold this button down while plugging in the power to the box. So you'll want to have your power supply already plugged into the wall. And then what we're going to do is hold down the button next to the screw, and I'm going to plug it in. And almost immediately you'll see a red light come on. When that light comes on, you can let go of the button and see if the red light, there we go. You can kind of see it between the button and the screw there. Once that's on, the CabControl is ready to take the update. So as we prepared our USB stick earlier, you'll just want to plug that in to the USB port on the back of the system. And the red light will start to flash. If you have any lights on your USB drive, they may also flicker for a little while the update's happening. They may stop flashing. Either way is normal. The key is the red light on the box. And so while the update's occurring, you don't want to do anything, don't want to unplug it. Make sure just to let it go. And it will take maybe up to a minute or so here. The update is relatively large and adds a lot of new features. So we're just gonna wait for it to complete. Once it's completed, it will reboot itself and then we can proceed. The update will basically be done at that point. And there we go, the red light went solid and turns off, and now the unit will reboot. You'll get a blue and a green light flash. There we go. And then the green light will slowly blink. And that means the unit has rebooted and you can now pull out your USB drive and replace the little window back on the top. And that's all there is to it to get the CabControl integrated control unit updated. Once you go into your throttle, you can then see the version 4.2.13 will now show for the version. And that's going to wrap this video. If you have any questions, feel free to email support@lokesound.com. Also visit our website at lokesound.com for more information on all of our products. Our decoders are going to work best with the CabControl system and these new updates. A lot of neat new bi-directional communication things and such like that. So I highly encourage you to take a look at the system and take advantage of the decoders and all new features. Thanks for watching. Keep enjoying your ESU products, and we'll see you next time.